Hey, what's up, you guys? Yes, welcome to Shiro Reacts. This time I will be reacting to Indie World. I did not make a prediction on this video, but that's because it's not a direct. And I don't classify it as one because it does not have direct in the title. And why is there noise outside? Literally, they just started mowing the lawn, someone. Fuck. I don't know if you can hear it. It's not that loud, but yeah. I'll put in theater mode, probably. I think that's probably the best mode. Because I don't want to get copyrighted. The audio will be a little muted. Not muted, but you'll be able to hear it, but it will be low so I don't get copyrighted. And yeah. Can I shut this chat off? It's bothering me. So I don't really have any predictions for the show other than I don't know, maybe sports story and stuff. Maybe more info on the Cadence DLC, because that's technically indie. I'm pretty sure. I don't even know. Another minute. So yeah, I don't really have predictions. I'm not really a huge indie guy, but I will watch this. I did wake up to see this early. I'm freaking tired, man. Holy crap. But I'll be fine. Alright, I'll skip to when it starts. Oh, here we go. The same morning that the last two directs had. Directs with quotes. Because they are many and partner. You know what? I'll go full screen. I have no idea what I'm looking at. I'm sorry if my voice is raspy. I literally woke up. Hades, the fuck? God of War spell. No, I'm just kidding.
On behalf of our small team at Supergiant Games, I am really excited to announce our roguelike dungeon crawler Hades is coming to Nintendo Switch.
You play as the prince
of the underworld, trying to escape hell. And each time you die, it's like coming home. You advance the story, get stronger, and gear up for your next escape attempt. It's a game you can sink dozens of hours into, and if you've already done so on PC, you'll be able to transfer your progress.
Jesus fucking Christ.
With cross saves. So if you like the fast-paced action,
that's cool.
Atmosphere, and character-driven storytelling of our past titles like Bastion and Transistor, we think you'll find something to love in Hades.
They didn't show any gameplay.
Hi everyone, and welcome to Indie World. I look forward at some games making their way to Nintendo Switch. I'm Mariko.
And I'm Tyler.
And that was a look into the Greek mythology and
now they show
dungeon crawler, Hades, from Supergiant Games.
In this game, you'll ally with members of the Greek pantheon, wield truly legendary weapons, and fight your way through the underworld as you attempt to escape the god of the dead.
Unleash the fury of Olympus when Hades makes its system debut on Nintendo Switch this fall.
Okay.
Wow, Artico, are we back in the 90s? It's so radical.
The hell?
With all of its groovy gifs.
Corey Paul? Is that Jake Paul's brother?
An amazingly useful toolbar. Hypnospace Outlaw is a portal back to the early days of the internet.
You mean GIF, right? Scour the weirdest corners of the net, dodge computer viruses, and hunt down hackers and other
the hell?
Villains. As you
internet simulator.
On the digital streets of
Switch. You can pre-purchase the game or download a demo of it from Nintendo eShop later today.
I have no idea what I'm looking at. I have no idea what I'm looking at. It can't be. I'm just kidding. People really think Fall Guys is gonna get announced in this. I'm like, I haven't played the game. It's one of those games I don't really want. I don't play. I haven't played it. You know?
Spirit Fair Stella, help the spirits of the dead make their way into the afterlife by transporting them across the seas on your handcrafted ferry.
Befriend passengers, customize your boat, explore an imaginative world, or just go wherever the wind takes you. While you may be transporting your spirit friends to the afterlife, it doesn't mean you can't have a little fun along the way.
You'll be able to set sail very soon as Spiritfarer makes its maiden voyage on Nintendo Switch later today.
Interesting. The fuck? Why does this remind me of Undertale? Like, the art style does, and like the character designs. Yo, what happened to Deltarune? Holy crap. I just freaking remember that. I feel like it's been like 2 years since Chapter 1 came out. It's gonna bother me. I have to look it up. I'm so sorry. Yeah, it was October 2018. Holy shit. Almost 2 years.
When times get tough, I hope players enjoy the world that I've created and perhaps learn to call it a home away from home.
Hi, I'm Jenny from Rose City Games. We're proud to be working with Pikogram to bring this game to life and super excited to announce Garden Story will be coming to Nintendo Switch, which means you'll be able to hang with fruity friends both at home and on the go.
The time is right, and there's a community to save. Wholesome action-adventure game, Garden Story.
While newly appointed Guardian Concord may only be a grape fresh off the vine, it's up to them to help rebuild their community and stave off the dangerous rot.
Cultivate friendships, gather precious resources, and restore buildings to help unite the grove so everyone can enjoy the fruits of their labor together.
Garden Story will bloom on Nintendo Switch next year.
Ah.
You've crash landed on an alien world, and the only way to go is down.
Surrounded by water on all sides, dive into.
Oh my god, they're fucking mowing lawn again.
Collect resources, craft underwater structures, and uncover just what happened to this watery world.
If you really want to delve deep, build your own submarine and discover the exotic flora and fauna that call this planet home. Just watch out for some of the more aggressive animals that may not take kindly to your expeditions.
And for explorers seeking a frozen adventure, the sequel, Subnautica Below Zero, will have divers trying to survive the frigid temperatures of planet 4546B. Subnautica and Subnautica Below Zero will both launch on Nintendo Switch next year.
Woo.
This animation style game really is something, Ariko.
As young game designer to be, Takeshi, your goal is to entertain your little brother Hiroshi with the latest chapter of your game in this charming RPG.
Choose the monsters that Hiroshi faces on his quest and craft cool challenges, but don't make things too difficult. You'll need to strike a delicate balance to make your game a truly unforgettable adventure.
Discover this heartwarming tale of brotherly bonding when Takeshi and Hiroshi launches on Nintendo Switch.
That is interesting, like a game in the game. I am sorry about that. Something happens. Sorry.
Nintendo Switch later today.
So I rewinded like about maybe 30 seconds. I don't know. I'm not mean to hit my mic. No, none of these indie games so far, like, none of them are like, damn, I really want to play this. Or like, oh, this is so cool. Like, I don't know. You don't see bad, but just like, She cut me off, and then I don't fucking remember what I was saying.
That dives deep into the rich tapestry of Indian culture, taking inspiration from Hindu and Balinese mythology. All of us here at the studio have grown up hearing such wonderful Hindu tales of epic proportions, surrounded by architectural marvels and the vast diversity India has to offer. We hope you'll enjoy playing Raji as much as we have loved and enjoyed making it. Defend the world against the forces of the mighty demon lord.
No. Raji, I don't want to.
In this intense action adventure, mastering divine weapons such as the fearsome Sharanga bow and the three
I should know.
Is vital kidding. To your survival.
Striking art based on ancient Bharat games and the medieval architecture of Rajasthan. This is an adventure unlike any you've seen before.
Polish your weapons and get ready to battle when Raji, an ancient epic, releases later today as a timed console exclusive on Nintendo Switch.
Nice. The hell? House simulator?
To attracting new customers, to managing your guests.
Is this a ripoff of the Spins?
Management adventure.
Let's just say Spins instead of Sims.
As fresh-faced so stupid. Hank, it's your job to turn
why is he a fucking bear? Why is he a bear? Bear BNB. Instead of a... I guarantee this game's called Bear BNB. It's gonna be called Bear BNB. There's old friends and new friends and even a bear.
What secrets are hiding out there in the wilderness?
Be among the first to book your reservation when Bear and Breakfast launches on Nintendo Switch as a timed console exclusive next year.
Lace up your walking boots, Ariko. We're going on a hike.
Explore the peaceful mountain landscapes of Hawk Peak Provincial Park in a short hike. A game all about going at your own pace.
I thought the stream was pixel. It looks like a DS game, like a 3D DS game. Like, actually, look at it. It does. Holy crap.
Make sure to say hi to the other hikers making their way around the park, too. They're bound to lend you a helping hand. You can even go for a jaunt on the water, should the mood strike you.
You'll be able to hit the trail very soon. The short hike launches later today on Nintendo Switch as a timed console exclusive.
I'm so tired, holy crap. Oh my god, these fucking motherfuckers. I'm sorry. So it encourages cheating. That's cool.
Felicent, cheat your way to the top of 18th century French society, Card Shark. A new adventure that's all about playing your cards right.
As you move from the parlor to the king's table, build up your array of card tricks and use your ill-gotten gains to buy your way into some truly high-stakes games.
Just make sure you don't get caught. Your fellow gamesters do not take kindly to cheaters.
Card Shark will make its opening gambit on Nintendo Switch next year.
I can't wait to see what this ends with, because you know that it's going to be a good announcement. I'm behind because I had to take a break. I'm sorry. I should just fast forward. No, I'm just kidding. Oh, I've been broke so many times, I don't know what to believe. Holy shit, man. I'm literally so fucking tired. I'm like yawning.
Those who wish to flaunt their glittering hoard, you can build your own forts, where you can upgrade and show off your gear to the world.
And animal lovers will be happy to know that pets make their return, complete with their own skill sets to assist you on your journey for even shinier plunder.
Your legend awaits when Torchlight 3 comes to Nintendo Switch this fall. And when it does, adventurers on Nintendo Switch we'll get this exclusive red fairy pen.
Holy crap.
I don't know about you, Tyler, but I feel like I'm in an optical illusion.
Manifold Garden draws inspiration from physics-defying artworks to create some truly mind-bending puzzles where gravity is yours to manipulate.
You'll need to change your perspective if you hope to navigate through these infinitely repeating structures. Don't worry about falling infinitely, though. Gravity will bring you right back where you started, should you take a wrong turn.
Wrap your head around these perspective-twisting puzzles soon.
As Manifold Garden releases later today on Nintendo
Switch. Holy shit, I'm literally about to fall asleep. Oh my god.
Hi, my name is Kent. I'm the director of Evergate.
And I'm Cynthia, and I'm the lead artist on Evergate. Evergate has been a passion project for the last 4 years. It is a dreamlike 2D puzzle platformer set in the afterlife, where you must guide a childlike spirit named Ki on a journey through life, death, space, and time.
With Evergate, we wanted to introduce a fresh new mechanic, the Soul Flame, that gives players an extraordinary flexibility in how they navigate the afterlife, while also giving an experience with heartfelt emotion that we hope will touch players with its innocence and humanity.
Thank you to everyone who has supported us in making this dream a reality. We are extremely excited to be bringing Evergate to the Nintendo Switch.
Help Ki traverse the afterlife in Evergate, a haunting yet beautiful adventure from Stone Lantern Games.
As you journey through this ethereal world, use Ki's powerful soul flame to slow down time and unleash the unexpected powers hidden within the mysterious crystals that dot the landscape.
With clever use of the soul flame, unlock the power of multiple crystals to solve challenging puzzles.
Experience this touching story about two kindred spirits when Evergate launches later today on Nintendo Switch. It's almost time for us to wrap this up, but before we go, here's a quick glimpse at even more indie games that our partners from around the world are currently hard at work on. Let's check them out.
Is it just me, or I prefer the name Nindy instead? Yeah. Fuck? What the hell am I looking at? Oh my god. In most. This looks like a Game Boy game. Well, not actually, no, it looks better than a Game Boy game. What am I saying? This looks like Undertale, too. Puzzle game? Kinda looks like, the graphics kinda look like Cuphead. A little bit, not that much though. Goner 2, I remember like the first game. I don't think I played it, but I remember it.
And that's our show. Thank you so
there's not gonna be, but there's one more thing.
Was that you, Tyler?
Yes. It can't be. Goose 7? No, I'm just kidding. Goose DLC? Two player and Goose? I never actually played Goose. Is there gonna be. Is it. Two and there's like co-op and stuff. That's it. That because that's actually kind of cool. But isn't it? I feel like it's early for two, so it has to be DLC, right? A free two-player update. That's and a fucking physical version. That's awesome. I might get the physical version because I actually never. Cop it.
Is it over?
No.
As always, it was a pleasure.
By the way, we're hosting an indie sale over on Nintendo eShop
nice.
On Nintendo Switch right now, including discounts on some of the games we showed in this presentation. Make sure to check it out later today.
Just checking if there's
on
anything
behalf
else.
Of everyone at Nintendo, a big thank you to all of our amazing partners.
Fuck off. Thank you guys for watching today's reaction video. It has been a one. Honestly, I'm not that big of an indie guy. But it was entertaining to see some of these. So yeah, see you guys in the next one. Bye.